The NCAA encourages and promotes sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. for vanity, racial, or ethnic comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. We thank you for your cooperation. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Missouri S&T in tonight's men's basketball game featuring the Greyhounds from the University of Indianapolis. And your Missouri S&T Miners! Ladies and gentlemen, the Great Lakes Valley Conference and its 14 other member institutions are mourning tonight with the University of Indianapolis following the passing of incoming men's swimming recruit Nicholas DeWard. Nicholas was one of the 17 victims who tragically passed away yesterday at Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida. Nicholas had visited Indy 3 weeks ago and committed to becoming a Greyhound. Just this past week, his future team, the Greyhounds, won its first ever GLBC Men's Swimming and Diving Championship. The GLBC is a family. When one of our schools hurt, we all hurt. We respectfully ask that you stand and join us in a moment of silence prior to the national anthem to remember Nicholas and the 16 other victims taken from us too soon. Starting lineup, starting with the Greyhounds. 6'7 junior forward from Indianapolis, Indiana, number 10, Jesse Gibson. 6'2 junior from Indianapolis, Indiana, number 14, CJ Hardaway Jr. 6'6 senior from Westfield, Indiana, number 20, Ajay Lawton. 6'6 sophomore from Greenfield, Indiana, number 24, Tim Carr. And 6'1 senior from Fishers, Indiana, number 30, Eric Davidson. And now here are the starters for UL Missouri S&T Miners! Check guard, 6'3 sophomore from Chicago, Illinois, number 5, DeLon Scott. 6'5 junior from St. Louis, Missouri, number 12, Ernst O'Reilly. 5'9 sophomore from Waynesville, Missouri, number 15, Joe Johnson. 6'9 junior from Sagaris Poland, number 23, Sebastian Merrick. And 6'7 junior from the Fort Saint-Alain, France, number 24, Romain Lucer. Final number is head coach Jim Glass, this is my arch homework, Jeff Eachaw, Tom Avery. Thank you. on, Scott. Three points. Ajay Lawton. David Paul. Great out fouls, number five, Alex Pettington. First personal, second time foul.
A champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division 2, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Thank you.
basketball. And the line for two remains the same.
Two. Time out on the floor.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division 2, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Come on!
17 times. At the line, from Missouri S&T, Chris Harris.
Classroom is anywhere I can open my tablet or laptop.
Missouri University of Science and Technology gives you an education that fits your life and your dreams.
Let's develop. number 24, Ravens there, second personal. 10th team foul on the line for the Ravens. Number 24, take off. And again for S&T, Sebastian Ferris.
Classroom is anywhere I can open my tablet or laptop.
Missouri University of Science and Technology gives you an education that fits your life and your dreams.
Number 23, Sebastian Ferris.
Basically found on the 23 special turn and second personal. Third personal, check that. At the line for the Greyhounds, it's one more, CJ Harvard Jr.
partnership with Blue Frame Technology, you can now watch your favorite Great Lakes Valley Conference sports on the new GLVC Sports Network Apple TV app. Easily tune in to live broadcasts or search through thousands of archived broadcasts. Have an older Apple TV? You can still watch on your TV by going to AirPlay on your iOS device and choosing Apple TV. Begin watching your broadcast now on the new GLVCSN app, available in the App Store.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship, found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours, the home of Division II college
Greyhounds, number 10, Jesse Kingston.
at the line for the Greyhounds 24 take all. Back the game for S&T, for T.J. Johnson.
Closer look at the world, you have to go beyond the surface. Because the things that are worth exploring don't happen on the ground level.
They go deeper.
And span wider than most people dare to consider.
But we're not most people.
And we don't see things the way most people do.
We uncover big ideas by looking in the unexplored spaces.
We find new understanding by jumping headlong into the unknown.
And wherever we focus our attention, we go all in.
We pursue big questions because we're curious.
We are different notes on the same page.
We put in the hard work because we're ambitious.
We look in new directions because we're inventive.
And we dig deeper because we are miners, and that's just what we do.
Explosives camp, you deal with everything explosives related. I know that sounds very general, but We do things demolition related, mining related, fireworks related, anything that uses any sort of explosives to bring down structures, to provide rock for concrete plant, whatever it may be, we cover it here.
Fire low! Fire low! Fire low!
3, 2, 1.
You learned a lot, but it didn't feel like boring sitting in a classroom and just having somebody lecture at you. Like the lectures, the couple that we had were interesting, and then they went and they showed you the actual physical application and you got to make it with your own hands.
We did a lot more stuff with explosives than I thought we would. I thought we'd do maybe one or two things a day, but it's been pretty much constantly we're doing something and just going forward and learning.
3, 2, 1.
Okay. Now,
5 seconds.
Now it's gonna be 5 seconds. Did they all go off at the same time?
No.
I think this camp is gonna help me with thinking more before I do stuff, because that's a big part of what they've pushed, is you can do anything as long as you think about it first. We've made shaped charges out of wine bottles that have shot through an inch of steel and an inch of industrial caterpillar track, which is pretty impressive. You just had to think about it. So really, it's think before you act.
Yeah, it's definitely useful information. Explosives are not that scary. People think that you touch it or you look at it wrong and it's gonna go off. And like, I guess it's just kind of shown that if you know what you're doing and you treat it with the amount of like respect that it needs, it's mostly safe to work with.
So being around these campers every day, all day, you get to understand kind of what their career goals and aspirations are. And from the field trips that we took, one particular student I remember, after we took him underground, he had an inkling that this is kind of the career he wanted to do. After taking him underground, he confirmed, he said, "I'm in heaven, this is where I want to go, this is where I'm going to be, I'm going to apply tomorrow." So that's very rewarding to help these young students confirm what they want to do in life and have successful careers eventually.
If you're thinking about coming, just come, and it'll probably be one of the best decisions that you have made during high school. It's a week well spent. You will not regret coming, because where else are you going to get to play with explosives and not go to jail for it?
Guys, explosives, fun, friends, away from your parents for a week. Safe for your parents if you see this.
As a little kid, I always got this curiosity to find out how technology worked. And I remember my dad sent me a remote control vehicle, and then I took the remote control apart and I took the car apart because I wanted to know how it worked. And then I couldn't put it back together. That intrigued me to go into the engineering field. I wanted to know how things work.
All right, go.
I was born in Honduras. I was raised by my grandmother and my aunts. I migrated to the United States when I was 12 years old. Then after high school, I went to the community college. From there, I transferred to Missouri University of Science and Technology. I'm the first generation in my family to attend university. Right now, I'm going in for my final presentation for my software engineering class. All my teachers, they've been really helpful. They're always there. If they're not available right there, they're always checking their emails.
And Luis, what do I have for the last point?
essential for team projects. For the classrooms are small enough that each teacher will be able to provide the attention that you need in order to become a successful student.
Right, now you push it.
The Society of Hispanic Professional Engineers, known as SHIP, has been a lot of help to me. It has helped me improve my communication skills, recruit to high school students, show them my pride for Missouri S&T.
Yes! Give me a high five.
Engineers Without Borders, they got me right into the team. They asked me, hey, can you help us translate? Can you make phone calls?
Ahora sí la miras.
I traveled to Santiago, Honduras, helped develop water treatment projects to help a community of about 8,000 people. So in 5 years from now, I see myself with a software engineering job and hopefully in a management position. You know, looking forward to be an inspiration for my siblings, as well as continuing working with organizations like Engineers Without Borders and being able to travel to third world countries and implement projects that will help other people.
Thank you. 3, Sebastian Ferenc is 4th. First team foul. At the line for the Greyhounds, number 10, Jesse Kimson. Back of the game for S&T, 32, Greg Long. Ajay, Lawton. S&T.
Sports Network Apple TV app. Easily tune in to live broadcasts or search through thousands of archived broadcasts. Have an older Apple TV? You can still watch on your TV by going to AirPlay on your iOS device and choosing Apple TV. Begin watching your broadcast now on the new GLVCSN app available in the App Store.
Yeah!
3 points, take all. Thank you. Island. Fourth personal, 14th foul. It's line for Indianapolis, and you lock. In the game for S&T, Joe Johnson and Sebastian Harris. Back in the game for the Greyhounds, 2014 home.
Scott.
way for the Miners, Lante Pickens and Irvin Sarabia.
My path to a college degree would have been completely different had I not had a scholarship. It would just relieve a lot of the financial burden.
Well, my bachelor's degree got me this far, but I believe I can go further. And I'm doing it online, on my own terms, and with a university that counts. one that's been around for almost 150 years. Because these days, I believe my classroom is anywhere I can open my tablet or laptop.
Missouri University of Science and Technology gives you an education that fits your life and your dreams.
Ending after Andy number 44. In the game for S&T, 15, Joe Johnson.
Thank you.
Into the game. For the Greyhounds, Jesse Kimson. And the line, Chris Harris.
Division 2, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
If I lose, I'll respond with respect.
If I win, I'll back it up with humility.
If I fail, I'll rise up with honor. It's tough for us to put it all on the line.
Don't undo my hard work with poor sportsmanship.
Respect. It's the name of the game.
Thank you.
for the game for S&T, Lawton Scott.
Thank you.
Floyd. Take all, fourth person. Shooting one, Ryan Lucy.
Come on!
Second foul is number 32, Greg Long. First personal. At the line for the Greyhounds, Eric Davidson. Second personal foul. The line for the Greyhounds, C.J. Harvey Jr.
That's not